Good morning, everyone. It's wonderful to be able to share this Mass with you today, even though we're only able to share it with you remotely. But because of that, we invite all of you to participate with us in what we call a spiritual communion. Obviously, we can't have you here with us in the chapel today to celebrate the Eucharist in person. So what we invite you to do is the next best thing, which is to really pay as close attention as possible to all of the readings and participate in the prayers and take an active role in the Mass, so that throughout the liturgy of the Eucharist, we invite you to be spiritually present with us, so that even though you're not here with us to receive the body and blood of Christ in person, the graces of the Eucharist will still flow into your hearts. And we ask you to please remember the souls of Marilyn Gerace and Michael Contadini, in both of whose memories this Mass is being celebrated by Father William. And with that, we'll begin. Thank you.
Your heads, grow higher, ancient doors. Let him enter, the King of Glory. We begin this celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, we gathered here once again to celebrate the Christmas Mass. Let us take a detour into our hearts, asking God humbly to forgive us our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who, seeing the human race falling into death, will to redeem it by the coming of your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that those who confess his incarnation with humble favor may merit his company as their Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. In those days, Hannah brought Samuel with her, along with a three-year-old bull, an ephah of flour, and a skin of wine, and presented him at the temple of the Lord in Shiloh. After the boy's father had sacrificed the young bull, Hannah, his mother, approached Eli and said, "Pardon, my lord, as you live, my lord. I am the woman who stood near you here, praying to the Lord. I prayed for this child, and the Lord granted my request. Now I, in turn, give him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he shall be dedicated to the Lord." She left Samuel there. The word of the Lord.
Thanks to God.
My heart exults in the Lord, my Savior.
My heart exults in the Lord, my Savior.
My heart exults in the Lord. My horn is exalted in my God. I have swallowed up my enemies. I rejoice in my victory.
My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior.
The bows of the mighty are broken, while the tottering gird on strength. The well-fed hire themselves out for bread, while the hungry batten on spoil. The barren wife bears 7 sons, while the mother of many languishes. My heart exults in the Lord, my Savior. The Lord puts to death and gives life. He casts down to the netherworld. He raises up again. The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He humbles. He also exalts. My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior. He raises the needy from the dust. From the dung heap, he lifts up the poor, to seat them with nobles, and make a glorious throne their heritage.
My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
O Lord, open my mind and my heart, so that I will be worthy to proclaim your gospel.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servants. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months and then returned her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Friends, as I introduced the Mass, that today is our Christmas Holy Mass. And most often during the Christmas Holy Mass, right after Mass is our short vacation that we are going to experience the joy of the newborn Christ into our hearts. But today I would like to draw your attention to 2 important things. The first reading is about Samuel, and it talks about the mother of Samuel. The first reading is about requests. Is it normally when we are in dire need, we go to our God and we begin to offer prayers upon prayers unto him? We say so many things, and sometimes we are in the position of telling the Lord that if he is able to grant my request, this is what I am going to do on my part. So more or less, we enter into a partial covenant with the Lord. It happened to the mother of Samuel. This woman called Hannah was experiencing a problem in her life. She had a husband, but this husband called Elkanah also had another wife. The other wife gave birth to children, but unfortunately, Hannah, the Samuel's mother, was barren. So it was something difficult on her. It was something that he could not bring herself to understand. So one day, this woman entered into the church, like the church we are here, and she began to pray. And out of this prayer, she was not even opening her mouth. She was just mumbling, telling God, pouring her soul before the Lord. And one thing that he said to the Lord was, if you are able to grant me a son, that son, I will offer him back unto you. So Hannah entered into a covenant with the Lord. Now, Eli happened to be the priest. And Eli saw her mumbling, and he came to her and he said, this is a church. If you are drunk, you need to go back. But over here we pray. And Hannah told Eli, the priest, that I am not drunk. I am pouring my soul before the Lord. I am crying before the Lord. In fact, I am carrying a load that it is only God who can offload it for me. And so when Eli realized the intensive prayer this woman was praying, Eli made a prophecy that a year by this time, you will come here with a child. Amen. This is what is going on in our lives. We have all kinds of problems in our lives. It could be sickness. It could be death striking in a family. It could be losing a job. Maybe your mom or your dad has lost his job. Or maybe you know a friend of your parent who have lost his or her job. It could be this COVID-19 that the world is battling. And so everyone had the opportunity to enter into prayer with the Lord. We have prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed. And thanks be to God, he is not deaf. He has heard all our prayer. Now Hannah had the opportunity to give birth. And Anna reinforced that covenant. He brought the son back into the church and offered the son unto the Lord, redeeming the covenant that he promised, making sure that he honored that promise. And now, when we come into our own lives, we also have made a promise to the Lord. Lord, if you are able to take away this kind of pandemic from our lives, if you are able to heal my mom or my dad or my son, or if you are able to heal a brother or a sister of mine, Lord, I know very well that I will give my heart unto you. And believe me, God is going to do that. And it is important that the promise that we have given to our Lord, we also honor that promise. By honoring that promise, we imitate Mary in the gospel. When God did all that he is supposed to do in the life of Mary, Mary did not sit down. He shared the joy with people. He shared the joy especially with Elizabeth and the family of Zechariah. And so the gospel says the first word that came from the mouth of Mary was, my soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. You can also say the same thing. You can add your voice to the voice of Mary and say, our soul will proclaim the greatness of the Lord. Why? Because today, the whole world is looking forward to this vaccine, right? The BioNTech vaccine that is coming. The whole world is looking forward to the Moderna vaccine. Why? Because God, in his own mercy, has granted people the wisdom and understanding to come out with this vaccine. We pray that through this, God will use human beings to eradicate this virus from our midst. It is my prayer that as we add our voice to that of Mary, we will also lift up our soul and say, our soul may proclaim the greatness of the Lord. My dear friends, if you are living in a kind of a bondage that it is difficult for you to lift up your soul, today is the greatest opportunity to release yourself. It is the greatest opportunity to release yourself from the temptation of lies. It is the greatest opportunity to release yourself from the tangle and the chain of, let's say, drugs or smoking or drinking. Today is an opportunity for you to release yourself from bad company. Today is an opportunity for you to tell yourself, I am better than this. so that the holidays that we are going to celebrate, the season of Christmas, will bring an edge joy onto your life. I would like to end this homily with what Mother Teresa said about life. He said, life is a challenge. Meet it. Life is a challenge. Meet it. Life is a promise. Fulfill it. Life is a journey. Complete it. Life is beauty. Praise it. Life is a struggle. Fight it. Life is a goal. Achieve it. Life is a puzzle. Solve it. Life is a gift. Accept it. Life is an adventure. Dare it. Life is a sorrow. Overcome it. Life is a game. Play it. Life is a tragedy. Face it. Life is a duty. Perform it. Life is a mystery. Unfold it. Life is a song. Sing it. And when you are able to do all these things, remember the last one, that life is an opportunity. Take it. May the greatest opportunity in our lives, the birth of Jesus, bring in its trail the blessings upon you, upon your family, upon the staff, and all those around you. May the Lord continue to bless all of us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. I now invite Mrs. Regan to come forward to lead us in the intercession. And let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may always reflect the joy of Jesus Christ, who enlightens our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the trees of light lining our campus may remind us of the tree of glory on which Christ accomplished our salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of Christ may dwell in our hearts and in our homes, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the students, alumni, faculty, and friends of Sacred Heart High School and Middle School may always reflect the light of Christ that they have received from the heart, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our international students will be supported by our generous hearts and tender, caring love in school and outside of our school community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That parents, godparents, and guardians who are taking care of a student will be protected by God and be filled with an abundance of blessings, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work in different departments at Sacred Heart High School and Middle School, as well as all of those who are generous with their time, talents, and treasures, will be shielded by the merciful love of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our middle school students will continue to avail themselves for the great and wonderful gifts of Sacred Heart High School in order to become great students and always raise the flag of the school high, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our elected officials will open their hearts for Christ in this season of Advent so they may be able to work for justice and peace based on divine mercy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we pray for those members of the Sacred Heart High School and Middle School communities whose names are listed in our Book of Remembrance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as we prepare our hearts for Christ, we remember and pray for our spiritual shepherds, Pope Francis, Archbishop Leonard Blair, our chaplain, Father William. May God continue to bless and guide them in their ministries. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those we remember with heart lights may be found in the fullness of God's promise. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that our loving God will continue to watch over and send his healing graces to those afflicted with COVID during this Christmas season, most especially those in our Sacred Heart family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In a very special way, we also remember Marilyn Gerais and Michael Contandini, that the good Lord receive their soul into the heavenly paradise. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Incline your merciful ear to our prayers, we ask, O Lord, and listen in kindness to the supplications of those who call on you. We humbly ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Trusting in your compassion, O Lord, we come eagerly with our offerings to your sacred altar, especially as we bring together our prayer intentions, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, and also receive your children, Marilyn Gerais and Michael Contandini, into your heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit,
lift up your heart. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Leonard, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, the Sacred Heart family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, especially Marilyn Jerez and Michael Contangine, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. Then we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the whole Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace by wishing everyone Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
stars all brightly shining, is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary soul rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn.
The greatness of the Lord. For the Almighty has done great things for me. Let us pray. May reception of your sacrament strengthen us, O Lord, so that we may go out to meet our Savior with worthy deeds when he comes and merit the rewards of the blessed through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks
be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust unto hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl around the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. In a very special way, I would like to thank Dan, thank Mike, and thank Mrs. Reagan for being present for this Christmas Mass.
Thank you, God.
We have not finished. Mrs. Reagan wants to give us a Christmas message. And so we invite Mrs. Reagan to come forward.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Dan. Thank you, Mr. Madden. And certainly thank you to all of you for joining us today for this special Christmas celebration Mass. On behalf of Mr. Azera and I want you to know that each and every day we pray for you, for your families, and we wish you God's choicest blessings this Christmas season. May the light of Christ be with each of you, and may the year ahead be filled with hope and joy and good health. Merry Christmas from all of us at Sacred Heart.
Thank you, Mrs. Reagan. And of course, we add our voice to that of Mrs. Reagan, wishing all of you Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Have a blessed day.